Good evening and welcome to this forum for council member for the City of Auburn Hills. Today is September 30th, 2019. This forum will be featuring those persons who have filed for council member. There are six candidates. Vote for four. The three highest vote getters will receive a four-year term. The fourth highest vote getter will receive a two-year term. Sponsor of this forum is the League of Women Voters Oakland Area. I'm Jerry Burton, a member of the League of Women Voters, and I'm not a resident of this community. The format for tonight's forum will be different than most of our forums where we have audience questions. We have written statements from three people who are unable to attend. Those will be read prior to the opening statements of the two people who are here and present. The candidates are Eugene Hawkins III, Brian Marsloff, Kevin McDaniel, Ron Monez, Cheryl A. Verbecki, and Craig Wetchy. I will read the candidate forms of the three people who are unable to attend. The first will be from Mr. Ron Monez. First of all, I'd like to thank the League of Women Voters for inviting me to this forum. Unfortunately, I am currently out of town at a conference with the city's Planning Commission members. I've been a resident of Auburn Hills for 30 years, married for 23 years with three children, and I have a small business here in Auburn Hills for over 20 years. I am proud to say that I live and work in Auburn Hills and raising my family here. I retired from the Public Service Department after 16 years and retired from the Auburn Hills Fire Department as District Chief after 20 years. We have a population of approximately 23,000 residents, but during the weekdays, we have upwards to 100,000 people at any given time based on the businesses, schools, and visitors. We are fortunate that 85% of our corporate businesses help support our world-class city. We need outstanding city services to support that many people. These same residents and visitors support our local economy by going out to eat, shopping, and filling their gas tanks in our community. Our city services, including Department of Public Works, that maintains the roads, infrastructure, plowing, and other various issues. The police department was just recognized by the Michigan Association of Chiefs of Police, ranking Auburn Hills Police Department 18th in the state to be accredited. Our fire department is growing as the city grows. They are comprised of men and women who work under the very stressful situations, but do their job with professionalism. Our award-winning senior services department continues to provide our residents with nothing but the best, and the same can be said about parks and recreation. I have and will continue to support what these great departments need to give our residents, visitors, and business owners the city services they expect and deserve, while being fiscally responsible as a steward for the City of Auburn Hills. With addition of the Knight Amphitheater and the splash pad downtown, we have certainly lived up to what our meetman says. The Auburn Hills is a great place to live, work, and play. With that, don't forget to get out and vote on November 5th, 2019. Good luck, everyone, and thank you, Ron Moniz. Our second statement will be from Eugene Hawkins, the third. Good evening, my name is Eugene Hawkins III. I am a candidate for Auburn Hills City Council in the upcoming election. I would like to thank the League of Women Voters for hosting the candidate forum this evening, my fellow candidates for City Council, and most importantly, the residents that have taken their time to learn a little more about the candidates that are seeking the opportunity to represent them on the City Council. I've been proud to call Auburn Hills my home for the past 24 years. My wife and I built our home and raised our son here, where he attended Avondale schools and is currently a senior at Michigan State University. I have a bachelor's degree from Michigan State University in criminal justice and a master's degree from Central Michigan University in human resource administration. I'm running for the Auburn Hills City Council to continue the work, dedication, and commitment to public service that I've shown by working in several organizations that serve others over the past two decades. As the business owner, I have the ability to listen, communicate, and work well with others. I will bring my work experience and professional experience from being an owner of an insurance agency for over 20 years. I have served in several leadership positions for many community organizations, including president of the Hunt Club Owners Association, member of the Pontiac Youth Assistance, chairman of the Auburn Hills Public Safety Advisory Commission, former coach at the Boys and Girls Club, a reserve deputy in the Oakland County Sheriff's Department, and a commissioner on the Law Enforcement Accreditation Commission. I welcome the opportunity to meet with the residents to further discuss my credentials, as well as important Auburn Hills matters that they are concerned with in our city. The last statement of a gentleman who isn't here is from Mr. Kevin McDaniel. First, I would like to thank all of the candidates that have committed to run for the Auburn Hills City Council in this upcoming November election. I've interacted with each and every one of you and know that you all are very passionate and care deeply for our community. I applaud you for all your willingness to serve our residents and know that regardless of the election outcome on November the 5th, the city will be in great hands. I am unable to attend this meeting tonight because of prior commitments and promises that I am unable to exchange. In my opinion, the league changed the date. The date of this candidate forum was originally September 25. The league was informed that there was a conflict in the city, and the date was changed immediately on September the 9th. All candidates confirmed they received the confirmation of the new date. To the residents of Auburn Hills, since I first became elected to the City Council in 2007 and then trusted by my fellow council delegates to serve as mayor since 2013, I have always been readily available and accessible. That will not change, and you can continue to contact me for an in-person meeting or speak with me by phone or email, whichever is most convenient. My contact information will continue to be made available as it always been, including my signature block of every email communication I have with residents, and the same direct contact information is listed on my business card. If anyone has questions, concerns, or needs clarification on any items of interest, including priorities of the city, you can contact me to reach out and have personal conversation or by phone and email. If you would like to make a note of my cell phone, 248-392-8593. My email is kmcdaniel@auburnhills.org. I look forward to personally speaking with you. Thank you for your support over the last 12 years. It has been an honor to serve as your mayor and city councilman, and I would appreciate your continued vote and confidence on November 5. I am excited to continue working for Auburn Hills and the families in the years ahead. Thank you, Mr. Kevin McDaniel. At this time, we will allow the candidates 7 or 8 minutes to give a statement, and we will start with Mr. Marshlov.
Okay, thank you very much. I really appreciate the opportunity to be here this evening. First, I'd like to thank the League of Women Voters for sponsoring this event this evening, and I'd also like to thank the City of Auburn Hills for hosting. The reason I'm running for City Council is I love Auburn Hills. I took a job with the City of Auburn Hills in 1989, and right after that, in 1990, moved here with my wife. Since that time, we've raised our family here. We have two kids, both in college at this time. Very proud of them and their accomplishments. During my 30 years of service here with the City of Auburn Hills, I've recently retired as the city's recreation director. But during that time, I was able to work with several of our past city councils, our past planning commissions, several of our advisory committees, and also the city staff in Auburn Hills to build the parks and recreation system that you see today from the ground up. Some of you may be familiar with some of the programs that we are offering still today. After-school activities, our summer day camp for kids, our T-ball program are very popular. Also, we've had some great facilities in Auburn Hills that we've developed over time. Some of you may be familiar with the Clinton River Trail, the skate park, and of course, the very popular community center. I've been honored to work with the people for many years, and also with our service organizations, our volunteers, and people that really care about Auburn Hills. I've also been president of the Noon Optimist Club of Auburn Hills. For the last 12 years, I've been the president. We work with our partner school is Rogers Elementary. We work very closely with the students here to enhance their lives and to make things better for them. Very proud of our work there, and volunteering has always been something that's important to me. I have some priorities for serving Auburn Hills. They start with seniors and veterans first. I feel strongly that our seniors need a place to live, not only live, but to thrive in Auburn Hills, and to have services that include nutritional services, including Meals on Wheels, a site meal where seniors can come together and socialize and have lunch at the community center, I think is very important. Also, transportation for our seniors, health and fitness opportunities, and volunteer opportunities as well. We have a lot to learn from our seniors, and I think it's important that we take care of them and make Auburn Hills a great place for them to live. I'm also interested in our veterans. I want to make sure that we have more recognition for all of our veterans in Auburn Hills. I think it's very important. Those veterans have given a lot of time and many of them their lives so we can have the quality of life that we have here today. I feel strongly about our veterans and working toward more recognition for them here. I'm also family friendly. I want to make sure that our parks, our pathways, our social events that foster community spirit continue. I think it's a great part of Auburn Hills. It helps make us the place that we are. I'm interested in what our young people have to say. I think it's important. We've established a teen council here in Auburn Hills. There are a lot of young professionals that are living and working in Auburn Hills, and I want to give them the tools and the opportunities to continue to be in Auburn Hills and to stay in Auburn Hills when they decide to make a home. I'm also interested in smart and balanced growth. And that means when development comes in, and we know it will, that we are looking to add value with those developments. So things like added sidewalks, pathways, parks, things that are going to enhance our city. Preservation of some of the natural areas so we can continue to have the beautiful city that we have is important to me. So I believe with my experience working here at the City of Auburn Hills for 30 years, along with my insight into the city operations and how things are decided on, including the budgets, the five-year capital plan, and master planning, I think are going to give me the tools that I need to help be a good council person. And finally, I'd like to further the vision of Auburn Hills, which is to be a community with the heart of a small town that offers world-class services. I'd be honored to serve the residents of Auburn Hills, and I want to wish all of our candidates the best of luck, and again, thank the League of Women Voters and the City of Auburn Hills for hosting this event tonight. Thank you very much. If anybody would like to get a hold of me, my phone number is 248-431-2350. I also have a website. It's titled votemarzoff.com, and you could check out our information there, and I'd really appreciate it. Again, thank you for this opportunity. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Marzloff. Our next speaker will be Cheryl Verbicki.
Thank you. Thank you. And I would also like to take a moment to thank the League for hosting us this evening. About 25 years ago, I learned of a piece of a property downtown that was being changed from residential to commercial. And what was sitting on the property became my home. I purchased it. I moved it to the north side of town after purchasing a piece of land, which was an experience because I had an opportunity to meet with numerous departments within the city of Auburn Hills, and I realized what a great community this was, and I was excited to be here. So 25 years ago, I became a resident, and shortly after that, I became involved by sitting on the Planning Commission. I was appointed to that committee, and then also the Tax Abatement Committee. Then 8 years ago, I was elected to the City Council, where I was a liaison during that time to the Beautification Advisory Committee and also the Public Safety Advisory Committee. I am a secretary of the Auburn Hills Boys and Girls Club Board at my kids' school. I am secretary of the PTO. My husband and I are foster parents, and we adopted 4 children from foster care. Recently, I was appointed by the state of Michigan Supreme Court to be on the Foster Care Review Board. And I'm also in charge of a chairperson for Blessings in a Backpack, where I feed children who are struggling in the community to make sure they have food on the weekends. I like to be involved in our community, and I like to try and help people. And I feel that being up here on City Council, that I have an opportunity to do that. By being a voice and an extension of the people that I represent, I feel that I can help to make the city better. I think it's a great city. We're very blessed in many ways in Auburn Hills. But I like being involved, and I would like to continue to be a voice. I know one of the hot topics for everybody throughout the state of Michigan is roads. We've talked about it here on the council. And I think that there's a variety of things that we can do. But I think we need to wait till the state does something, whether or not they make us whole or they do some kind of funding to provide that for the communities. And then I think we need to go the next step. But I think we're sort of on hold until that happens, unfortunately. But I'm really hoping that the people at the state level will come forward soon with something to help us. On council, we're also in the process of doing our 2020 budget. We are in a great place in Auburn Hills. We are very well funded in our pension, as well as the events and the departments and the different things that we're doing throughout the community. Our fire department recently received a SAFER grant, which will enable us to add 3 firefighters very soon. This is exciting news for our fire department, but as our community as well, so that they can continue to provide additional services and to provide amazing services to our residents. And I think that we do that. I think not only our police department, our fire department, our seniors community center, the Parks and Recreation Department, I think we do a great job of providing amazing services to our residents. And I definitely need to say that the DPW does a great job of maintaining the snow removal and anything, the grass, you know, anything that is falls under their department. They do an amazing job. When you're in the wintertime, when you get into Auburn Hills, you know it, because they do a wonderful job of making sure the roads are safe and clear for our residents and all those residents that are traveling throughout Auburn Hills to get to their jobs. I just would say thank you for your support up till now, and I would hope that you would continue to support me. We are a blessed community in so many ways, not only having a wonderful staff, but our residents, and I would like to continue serving you. I'd be honored to continue doing that, and if anybody has any questions that they'd like to contact me, please do so. My email is cherphil@gmail.com, or I can be reached at my home phone number, at my cell phone number, 248-909-5689. Thank you very much for having us this evening, and I appreciate it.
Thank you, Cheryl. And while the two of them were talking, I thought of two good, real good questions. Then the first question, we'll start with Mr. Marzloff. With the continued reductions in revenue sharing and information from the state, what are you going to do to maintain the budget to help your city?
Well, we're going to be creative, and we're going to work together, and we're going to talk about things, and we're going to make sure that the revenue is there for the city, and we'll make sure that our roads are up to standards, and it's important for us. We all know that, and that's what I would do.
Thank you, Ms. Verbicki.
Thank you. One of the things I think Auburn Hills is wonderful about doing is sharing services and equipment with our neighbors. Sometimes we might need a a piece of equipment that we wouldn't use very often. So we would share it or, you know, give a little bit of money to a neighboring community to borrow it on a short-term situation. And so I think that's one of the things, ways that we can continue to share, you know, to receive things, but without having to purchase it. But as far as the revenue sharing goes, recently there was a lawsuit at with the state because the state government went against the state constitution and they reduced our funding at the municipality level. And just recently, there was a decision made where the municipalities won that. So we should be seeing some relief and additional funding should be coming to the municipalities very soon. We don't know what that number is, but we're waiting to see, and I'm sure that will help the bottom line.
Thank you. And next question and the last question will be for Ms. Verbicki. What are the ideas from the city for the palace property?
Well, we changed the zoning for that property so that it would be more marketable. But right now, we're waiting. It's not something that we own, so it's something that we have to wait to see what the people out there who are interested in developing, what their desire is, and we'll have to wait and see, basically, hopefully it'll be very soon that a decision will come forward to provide a good tax revenue to the city with whoever decides to be there.
Thank you. Mr. Marslov.
I would agree with Ms. Verbicki on that, and I'd also rely on our expert city staff to help the city council decide some of those things. I know they work very closely together, and have done some excellent planning in the past, including exercises on what the future of the Palace of Auburn Hills will be. So I would rely on their expertise in advising the council.
Thank you. I have two closing statements from candidates who are unable to be here. The first will be from Mr. Hawkins. Thank you again to League of Women Voters for hosting this forum. As a member of the Auburn Hills City Council, I will continue to work with dedication and commitment to public service that I've shown over 20 years. I've held several leadership positions in many organizations that serve and assist others. I have a tireless work ethic and strong leadership skills and the ability to communicate and work well with others. I would love the opportunity to represent the residents by serving on the Auburn Hills City Council. Auburn Hills residents would like to learn more information about me and my campaign can visit my website at www.eugenehawkins.org. I look forward to meeting with more residents. Please visit my website. Thank you in advance for your vote, and don't forget to vote on November 5. Second closing statement would be from Mr. Ron Moniz. In closing, as your representative on City Council, I am committed to working with my fellow colleagues to focus on fiscal sustainability of this great city, to keep it moving forward in the right direction, being fiscally responsible in our number one priority on a daily basis, and I will continue to focus on this. I am proud to say that I've attended 100% of our council meetings and also the Planning Recreation Commission meetings since I was elected in 2017. I will continue my commitment to my constituents by meeting with them, taking their phone calls, answering their emails, and listening to their issues. While doing my best to resolve them almost on a daily basis, I have an open door policy. I want to help the people that put me in this position of this great city. I won't make any promise that I can't keep. I won't tell you one thing and do another. I do what I say I'm going to do. It may not always be what you want to hear. I treat people the way I would want to be treated, have stayed true to myself and my beliefs. I extend the thoughts because it's important that you know who you're voting for. I would like to ask for your support and re-elect Ron Moniz, November 5, 2019. And now, right now, if the candidates would like to have one more minute, we'll start with Ms. Verbicki.
Thank you. I would just say that there are seven different people that sit here on the City Council, and we're all unique. We come from different backgrounds, and we work well together. We don't always agree. We debate things, but I really think there's a level of appreciation for what we do here and a level of respect for each other. And it is my honor and pleasure to sit here as a council member. I hope I will continue to do that by receiving your vote, which I am requesting on November 5th. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Mr. Marslow.
Thank you very much. Again, I just have to say that I love Auburn Hills, and I've loved it since the day I moved here. And I'm looking forward to working with all of the residents, the local businesses, large and small, our nonprofits, all of our service clubs, and everybody that we can get together and work together with to make Auburn Hills the great place that it can be. Thank you very much. And again, I want to thank everybody for their support until this point, and I ask for your vote on November 5th. Thank you very much.
This concludes the forum. The League of Women Voters would like to thank the city clerk and her staff, Auburn Hills TV, for making this forum possible. For further information on the candidates, check with the League of Women Voters website for our voter guides. The voter guides went online today. That's lwvoa.org. They're also on vote411.org. When known, rebroadcast times will be posted on the League of Women Voters website and also on the Auburn Hills City website. The League of Women Voters is funded by contributions from concerned businesses and citizens. Our membership is open to men and women over the age of 16. The National League of Women Voters has suspended dues for students for 2 years, so students can join for free for the next 2 years. Remember to vote November 5, 2019. Democracy is not a spectator sport. Thank you and good night.